Good morning, RCS. Today is Friday, February 21st, and this is the RCS News.
Mark your calendars for the RCS Five Below shopping event. Shop anytime between March 29th and April 11th at the Ellisburg location, and RCS will receive 10% back. Information will go home in the green envelope and on the RCS website.
This is a great way for RCS to earn valuable dollars for our school. With all the talk of the viruses and flus around the world and in our community, are you doing enough to keep yourself and others safe?
Proper hand hygiene, according to the Centers for Disease Control, is the number one defender against the spread of illness.
The problem? People tend to wash too quickly. Here with more is WRCS's own Jack Tartamosa.
When some of us fall ill, we begin to wonder what brought on the coughing, sneezing, and aching. We might blame a sniffling person in the checkout lane or an office pandemic.
Obviously, there are many ways to catch a viral or a bacterial infection. But the single best way to minimize that risk is to wash your hands. And while that might seem simple, it is, after all, a skill taught to us as children. You may not be doing it correctly. Popular Science recently highlighted the importance of hand washing, noting that people may touch their face up to 52 times per day. If they've just touched the surface that's harboring germs, that's 52 opportunities for pathogens to settle in the mucous membranes and lash out with everything from flu to respiratory infections. The problem? People tend to wash too quickly, sticking their hands under the faucet for a few fleeting moments and moving on. In 2018, the U.S. Department of Agriculture evaluated 383 subjects and found that most did only a cursory wash. It's better to follow the CDC's advice, which is to get your hands thoroughly wet with very warm water, which can be enough to kill some microbes, and then lather up, making sure to reach every fold and surface area between your fingers, around your wrists, and under your nails. So far, this is not the stuff of surgical scrubbing, but here's where most people drop the ball. Rather than soap up for just a few seconds, try to keep the cleaning going for 20 seconds. That's two cycles. Obviously, washing after using the bathroom is a must, but you knew that. As for hand sanitizer, it's good for when there's no running water available, but it can't kill all germs, and it won't do a whole lot if there's visible dirt or grime on your hands. Water and soap remain the gold standard.
Thanks, Jack. Great information. Thanks for helping keep RCS healthier. This is the second feature this week in an attempt to help keep RCS informed and safe. A very special thank you to our special presenter, Merchantville firefighter, and RCS student, Christopher Patty, for his fire safety report yesterday. Families should watch the report and make a fire plan just for your family.
Just a quick reminder that this evening is eighth grade night for our girls' basketball team. Come out and support the girls. Emma, Madison, Kaylin, and Gisella will be honored as they end their RCS hoop careers.
Finally, let's take it into the great weekend with birthdays. Have a great day and a great weekend, RCS. Take it away, Mrs. Webb.
Good morning, it's Mrs. Webb here with birthdays. As you can see, we have lots of girl power. I am going to start with our first grader. Can you share with everyone your name?
Hi, my name's Aisha, and it's my birthday.
And how old are you?
7.
And did you already get your presents, or will you get them when you go home?
I already got the presents.
Oh, what did you get?
I got a dog balloon that I can walk. A singing balloon.
That is totally cool. What else?
A mermaid balloon and a balloon that was shaped like a 7.
Oh my gosh, I want to see those balloons. You're going to have to take a picture. That's so cool. Are you going to have a birthday cake tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I hope you get all your wishes come true, okay?
When I get home, because I'm going to a water park, but first I'm going to go to a hotel. It's only open on Sunday.
Oh my gosh. Well, you have an awesome time. That is an awesome birthday. And you, how old are you, my love bug?
I'm 8 and a half.
Oh, so you're a half birthday. So when is your actual birthday?
My actual birthday is August 15th.
Oh, okay. So you're usually having fun in the sun on your birthday, huh?
Yes.
Well, happy half birthday. And Rafaela?
Yeah.
Your birthday?
It was the 20th.
It was the 20th, and what did you do on your birthday?
Well, before my dad took me to New York, and on Saturday I'm going to have my birthday party.
Very cool. But you did something fun yesterday.
Yeah.
Tell me something cool about your birthday.
I share it with my mom.
Shares it with her mom. And what did you get to do at lunch?
My mom took me to a restaurant.
Oh, very cool. Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm a little jealous because she got to leave school for a little bit. Okay. And you, Miss Vivian, when is your birthday?
It's August 20th.
So she's another one who has fun in the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you go down the beach or the pool? Well, you hope you have a great birthday when it actually comes.
Thank you.
And then, Miss Quinn, when is your birthday?
Today.
Today. And how old are you, Quinn?
12.
Oh, almost a teenager. God help us. So what are you going to do for your birthday?
On Saturday, me and my best friend are spending the entire day together.
Oh, really cool. What are you going to do?
We're getting like our hair done, nails done, and we're just hanging out.
Oh, a girl day. Now I'm officially jealous of you, too. Well, that's it for birthdays. Everybody say bye.
Bye. Bye.